Hi everyone and welcome back. So in this video we are going to talk about use reducer hook. Okay, so before that we will have a quick recap whatever we have done. So we talked about use state hook and use effect hook. Okay, so these are just like some kind of a note I wanted to give you, that don't do these kind of mistakes when using the hooks. Okay, so the simple one I'm talking about use state hook. Okay, this is your initial state object, and now what you are doing is you are set state error, right? You are setting the whole object and setting only the single property. Now if you see this, after writing this particular line, your state object will have only single property, everything is gone, right? So always what you can do is you can always keep the existing state and the property which you wanted to update. So what happens with that is only loading property will change, rest of the state object will be same. So with the spread operator you are actually like merging the new properties of the state with the existing state. So always keep that in mind, you are not overriding the whole state by just using set state and here passing the full property. Okay, you can always use spread operator, that is your friend, and you can just override only few properties out of it. You can override any property you want, like I want to put some error message, something like this, so it will change this error message. Okay, now use effect, we have already talked about. If you just talk about use effect, then always try to take care of these dependency which you are passing. If you're not having any dependency, always keep that as an empty array so that it should not get invoked every time whenever something is getting changed in the component. So use effect hook can be used for many places. First of all, like making initial call, which is like one time, like making a call and getting data. So once component is rendered, you will be making a call and you will be getting data and you are saving it. That's it. Another use case is you wanted to trigger some logic after changing a particular state, right? So in that case, you will be passing this as a dependency. Okay, so that state can be a count. So when the count is getting changed, you are actually calling the use effect method, right? So it can be any kind of dependency, count, key or whatever. So these are something which can change. If these are getting changed, then only use effect will get called. So this will get called once after you are doing initial rendering. After that use effect will be triggered only if this count and key is getting changed. Okay, another usage which we see is if you wanted to actually watch changes on props or a state, right? We were using this as a watcher. Here we provided A and B. What it is? It is like a watcher we have added for these props which we are receiving from the parent component. If whenever we see that there is a change in the props, this use effect will trigger. So we were doing this same logic with the component will receive props, where whenever the props is changing in a child component, then we need to execute some logic. So this is also possible with the use effect. The main objective of use effect is to do subscription and unsubscription. So there may be a cases where you have to subscribe a particular service, and then once you are done, you will be actually doing cleanup for that service. Okay, so here you will be unsubscribing for whatever you have subscribed, like WebSocket event, observable, or a particular stream, or a DOM event, or anything. So this method is actually used for cleanup. So here the point is always take care of cleanup in use effect. Okay, and mostly use effect is actually used to write something which is actually happening initially either or after every render. Because use effect is a replacement of component did mount and component did update. It is component did mount and component did update lifecycle. Okay. So mostly in the examples we have seen that we were using it just to make an API call, get the data, set the state, and then if something is getting changed, if you wanted to call this again, we were passing the dependency. Always use this dependency array. This dependency array and specify your dependency. Okay. Another thing is, do not update state if you are not passing dependency array. That means do not do anything of any kind of use set state here. Set state means anything, set count, set data or anything. In that case, it will go inside a loop, right? So it is doing set state, state will change, again the render will get called, then it will come back again, so it's like a loop will come, right? So in that case, you should always have the initial dependency as an empty array. Okay, these are the pointers, quick recap. Now, in the next video, what we can do is we can start talking about use reducer, which is extension of use state. Currently in the use state, what we are able to do is we are initializing some state. What if we want to have a behavior same as a reducer functions, who are returning us some new state based on the action we were dispatching? Here we are getting only this action set C and it is just updating the initial state. What if we wanted to have some kind of a dispatcher which can dispatch different kind of actions and we can get a different state out of it? Reducers are like a pure functions which are just taking the initial state and the action as an argument. Okay, so this reducer example we have seen, if you have already done a little bit of Redux, then you might be aware about this. So like const initial state, so initial state, consider this is 0. Okay, I have written reducer function which is actually taking two argument. So in two argument it takes, first is a state and second argument is action. And here what we do is we write a switch case, I mean you can write anything, based on action we actually going to return the state here. So if case is action is add, okay, you will return some state plus one. Okay, if your action is something else, you will keep doing this. If your action is subtraction, you will do state minus one. Okay, so all their logic, it's you, this use reducer is actually extension of use state. Here we are in the reducer function, we are passing state and action, and based on action we will keep returning the new state. And how to actually combine this or couple this in the your function? So this is your actually component, const component. So you can write use reducer with the initial state. So initial state, your initial state can be anything. So this is how we will invoke this use reducer function. Okay, so this reducer here is this function we are passing and the initial state. So count will initially will be 0. Now with the help of this dispatch, you will be able to call dispatch method add, subtraction or whatever, right? So let's see that in the detail in the next video.